up, bimbos of bimbos? I hope everyone is doing good mentally, physically, and mechanically. If you're new here, my name is Haley, and today we are replacing the stock radiator on the STI with a Mishimoto radiator. I've been checking my temps, oil levels, fluids, everything, and the motor has about 700 miles on it. And I was driving home from school, and I made it maybe 10 minutes down the road, and my access port said 243, and my regular gauge was just blasted on high. And so I pulled over into Wawa, and there was just coolant and smoke everywhere, and it was a bad day. My dad actually came and saved me, and he helped me figure out that the radiator was cracked from the top. So when you go like this, I don't know if you can hear that, but it makes an air noise. So now we're gonna replace it. These hoses out, this one, the mounts, I think. Oh, I gotta do that bottom one for the water pump. And then I'm gonna just lift this power steering thing out the way. Please let go. There we go. Also forgot to mention to disconnect the cooling fan connector thingies. We did it! We freaking did it! I'm gonna clean this. What the f? Nice. I'm gonna clean this up and then we are gonna unbox the new one. I'm going to transfer the fans and the reservoir over to the new radiator. To do this, we just have to take out these two bolts right here and this one for this little thingy majiggy. And with the coolant reservoir, there's a little bolt right here and then you have to pop the tab on the right.
It already looks so good. Oh my god.
Ah. Yo. All right, look, this is obviously the new one.
Hi, puppy. Hi, puppy.
So you can see the old one was a lot skinnier than the new one. So hopefully that's not gonna make it harder to fit. But look at the new cap they gave me. So cute.
Okay, so this is cool. First of all, we got the hardware, which is good because my impatient ass that didn't read the directions thought we had to reuse those bolts, but we don't. So we got new bolts, then we got an air freshener and a little pamphlet. Okay. One thing I will say is these, I mean, all right, so they fit, obviously, they line up, but you gotta like really push them in. But it does line up, all the holes are good. So we should be good.
So I got the bottom water pump hose on. I'm gonna replace these with the Mishimoto ones, but just for now, I'm rocking the stock ones. Fans are connected. Now I think it's just time to put the coolant in and bleed it, which I'm really nervous for, but it's fine, it'll be okay.
And it's a new day, I'm in a new outfit.
Fashion Nova, you already know. Got my nails done and I already bled the coolant, but I'm gonna tell you really quick how I did it just in case you're doing this at home. I've seen a lot of videos that have shown me different ways, but the way that I did it seemed to work out the best, and so I want to share it with you. First things first, keep the car level, don't lift it or whatever they say. I'm sure that can work, but this is just what worked for me. So to start, you're gonna take off this upper coolant reservoir thing, take off the cap, fill it up from there. You're gonna keep filling it until you see kind of like all the bubbles go away and it'll hold itself. And sometimes you can hear it in the radiator as it starts to fill and the air is getting pushed out. But I was told the reason that you're gonna start here is because if you think about it, if you started in the core, you would have to be pushing all that air through the block. If you start up here, you're just pushing it through and out the radiator. But I'm sure each one works, potato, potato. Anyway, fill that up, then fill up the core, and then only fill this up a little bit. Once you turn it on and start to bleed it, a lot is gonna go into the expansion tank, reservoir overflow thingamajiggy. So yeah, that's that. I did test drive the car. The only issue I'm having is the hose right here coming from the water pump to the radiator. That one is leaking a little bit. I need to tighten it, but whatever, we'll get to that. Next up, we are going to be replacing this boost controller with one from Cobb. So like I said, new coolant, new radiator, all that is done. All we have to do is replace the boost controller, but I'm gonna do that in another video because this one has just been crazy and now the AC is turning on, so it's loud. But yeah, I appreciate the support and all you guys just keeping up with all this build. It's been crazy, it's been stressful, but it'll pay off on Thursday at the dyno. And yeah, if you think you know what power we're gonna make, put in the comments below. That's it, I'm done with this video. I love you guys, bye.